Hi, I'm Gopal Masalamani, and I am a product owner in Equinix. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to a new feature, e-access EPL connection for Equinix Fabric release April 2022. This is a new Ethernet service offer, using which we can offer to particularly a carrier who want to bring customers onto the network using Fabric. This feature helps Equinix Fabric network service provider to enable customers to access the network using an industry standard access service where NSP is not required to manage CTACs or VLANs on behalf of their customer. Now, let me log into Fabric portal. Click on Create Connection. Here, use the option My Own Assets. We have three ways to create a connection between assets. E-access EPL connection option is available under the Connect as E-access. E-access EPL connection is created between QNQ port and untagged EPL port. That is, either QNQ port can be A side while untagged EPL port is on Z side, or untagged EPL port is on A side and QNQ port can be on Z side. In this demo, I will walk you through creating e-access EPL connection using QNQ as A side port and untagged EPL port as Z side port. Let me choose Create Connection and proceed further. Here, let me select a QNQ port in Silicon Valley as my A side port. And I'm going to select an untagged EPL port from same Silicon Valley location as my Z side port. As you can see, I'm creating e-access EPL connection. Once I have selected A side as my QNQ port, in Z side, only untagged EPL option is available for selection. Other QNQ ports are disabled with a message as this port type cannot be used to create a connection with an selected A side port. Now, let me proceed to the next step. Here, I'm entering the connection name and outer tag. So let us call this as demo. E-access EPL connection. And I will use the outer tag as 231. And I'm selecting the connection speed. Right after, I'm able to view the connection pricing information. Now, I'm proceeding to the next step. Here, I'm able to review all connection details and submit the order. Now the order is successfully submitted and the connection provisioning workflow is kickstarted. Now I can use the connection inventory link to navigate to the inventory and view the status of this connection. As you can see, now this connection is successfully provisioned. I can click on the connection and go to the connection details. And here I can do the bandwidth change, or I can edit the connection name as usual, like other connections. This completes this demo. Thanks for watching.